Hello everyone, and welcome to another video from the team here at blendertech.com. That's blendertech.com. Don't forget to remember, create your way. Today we will be going into more details about your first animation. I'm simply going to show you how animations work and how to do a simple animation within Blender. I won't be showing you how to actually export it to a movie file, add sound effects, or do complicated character animations. I'm just going to show you the basics as an introduction and as an addition to my Zero to Heroes series. So let's get started, shall we? The information here will probably allow you to figure out how to do almost any animation you need to. I'm going to explain how to do animations with translation, rotation, and scaling. I'm going to explain keyframes. I'm going to explain the timeline, and I'm going to show you what can be animated. So let's get started, shall we? So first we're going to add in our standard cube. This is going to be the object that we are going to be animating today. So animation is quite simple. I believe in the default settings, with your default theme, you'll have the timeline down here. If not, split your windows and select timeline. The timeline shows you where your keyframes are, how many frames you have in total, and allows you to go and select where you want to insert your keyframes. It also allows you to play your animation with the simple play and pause buttons. There's also this record button, which allows you to record keyframes automatically, but we're just going to be learning how to insert keyframes with the I button to insert and Alt I to delete. So let's create our first animation. Start at frame 1 on the timeline, and then press I to insert a keyframe, and you have a whole list that you can choose from. Location, for example, would just take the info of where the location of the object is in its current state. Rotation would only take the information of how the object is rotated, nothing else. One that people commonly use is just lock rot scale, which stands for location rotation scale. So this will allow you to transform, scale, or rotate your object in any way, and it will pick it up as data in your keyframe. So that's what we're going to be using, but you can play around with the other ones. So insert a lock rot scale keyframe by pressing I and then clicking it. You will now see where our object name is has turned orange. That means there is a keyframe for the object in the current frame. If I go forward a frame, it turns back to white because there's no keyframe here. To delete a keyframe, make sure you have your object selected where the keyframe is. Go to the frame that has the keyframe, or press the back button that will say jump to the previous or next keyframe, or use the left and right arrow keys, or use the up and down arrow keys to jump keyframes. And then when you're in the window, hit Alt I, and it will say, it'll basically confirm if you want to delete the keyframe. So delete the keyframe, and it's now gone. And you can see the text has changed back to white. But we want this to be our first keyframe, so we're going to insert our lock rot scale keyframe again. Now jump ahead, say 1 second. I currently have my frame rate set as 30 frames per second, so that means for every 30 frames, 1 second of animation will play. I have 300 frames set, so my default animation would be 10 seconds long. Standard stock is 250 at 24.97 frames, I believe. For example, that's what this video is recorded in. So at frame 30, let's move it just randomly. Let's rotate it a little bit. And let's scale it up. Now insert another keyframe, lock rot scale, and then let's jump forward another 30 frames to 60. Now let's move it a little bit. Let's scale it, and let's rotate it. Now insert a lock rot scale. And then let's jump to the very end, and let's get it somewhere near the beginning. and insert our Lockrot scale. So now as you scroll back, you will see how your animation plays. One thing to note, when you're doing an animation by stock, it will start off going slow, then it will speed up to a linear point, I believe, and then it will slow down again. You can change this in the F-curve editor, and I will show you how to do this in a later video. So let's play our animation just to see what has happened. Again, you can choose the up and down arrows to jump keyframes, so let's jump to the first one, and let's zoom in a bit so we can see the whole area. We'll hide the camera for now, and let's hit play. There you have it, your very first animation. As you can see, the closer your keyframes are together, the faster the animation will happen. The further apart your keyframes are, the slower it will happen. You can animate anything, not only just location, rotation, and scale, but you can also insert keyframes for any sort of data, like input of some sort. Let me show you an example. So in the materials tab, I've added just a simple material that diffuses to a white color, or also known as turns our cube into a white color. We can animate the color. So on frame 1, we're going to have it as white. So hover over the color area and hit I. You will now see that there's a yellow border around here. Sometimes the box will just turn yellow, but that tells you that you now have a keyframe with data on the timeline. If we move to, say, just some other random frame, you'll see now that it's changed green. That means that we've now moved to a different location. Now we're not on the original keyframe, but it's letting us know that this data, this color, is being animated. So we can choose a different color here. Let's make it get greener and greener. Hit I to insert another keyframe, and as you can see, it's turned orange again with the border. Now we'll just jump forward, change the color, and hit I. Then we're going to jump forward. We'll change it to around the color wheel to lime green. Hit I, and then somewhere near the end, we'll all jump to an off yellow. Insert I, and at the very end, the last frame, we'll go back to white, or as close to white as I can get. There we go. Now hover over and hit I to enter a keyframe, and now let's watch our animation. Let's hit play. Jump back to our original keyframe and hit play. As you can see, it's changing colors at different times. You will not see this because we have not given it a texture data or anything, but if you were to render it, you would see this. But if you move your mouse over this, you can see how it changes the color slowly. To be able to see this in the 3D view, you would have to animate the viewport color. I think that's all the data I'm going to include about animations for now. In following videos, I will do more complicated animations, such as character animations, and animating some more different values, and doing things that are a lot more interesting. But this should be a guideline that should get you animating anything that you'd like. Thanks for watching our video from the team here at BlenderTech.com. Again, that's BlenderTEK.com. If you enjoyed this video and learned something, please like it, and don't forget to subscribe for more Blender, Unity 3D, and programming videos. We try to add between 3 to 10 videos a day. If you disliked this video for some reason, please leave a comment or email the team at info@blendertech.com as to what you did not like and what we can improve on, and we will change it as soon as possible. We also take requests for tutorials, so let us know what you want or want more content of. See you next time, and remember, create your way.